Good afternoon. It's Tuesday, August the 22nd, and I'm kneeling in a field of P006 T46R soybeans near Giroux, Manitoba. I just want to provide a quick update on the spider mite populations, which we've touched on in our last two videos. Continued hot, dry conditions, combined with drought stress in a lot of soybeans, means that the population of spider mites has absolutely exploded in many fields over the last week or so. You'll generally see spider mite damage first along field edges, driveways, where grassy areas or forages have been cut, or in ditches or fields where late applications of herbicides were made. Adult females can lay up to 100 eggs, which is one of the reasons why populations climb very quickly. In addition, natural predators, including ladybugs and lacewing, are generally still busy eating soybean aphids. Due to their minute size, it's impractical to have a spray threshold in terms of numbers of spider mites. It's more important to look at how much damage your soybeans are actually incurring and make a decision from there. Generally, we use a 0 to 5 scale. At 0, you're not seeing any damage on the soybeans. At a stage 1, you are starting to see some of that stippling in the lower canopy. Stage 2, you're seeing more stippling in the lower canopy, as well as some lower leaves starting to yellow. For stage 3 damage, you're seeing those colonies of spider mites heavily infesting the middle canopy and starting to move upward from there. You're also seeing a lot of yellowing in the lower canopy, as well as some leaf drop. This is your spray threshold for spider mites in soybeans. At stage 4, lower leaf yellowing is readily apparent, leaf drop is starting, the stippling, webbing, and mites are common in the middle canopy, and the mite and minor stippling are present in the upper canopy as well. At this point, we are looking at an economic loss. Once the lower half of the plant has lost its leaves, there's quite a bit of stippling in that upper canopy, as well as some crinkling of the leaves. You're basically at a stage 5, which is quite a bit past spraying thresholds. A couple of other things to keep in mind is that a pyrethroid insecticide is not going to control spider mites the way it does soybean aphids. You are going to have to use an organophosphate. This also means that you have about a 30-day pre-harvest interval. So if you are considering spraying, make sure you get out there and make that decision soon, because if these dry conditions continue, we will be harvesting within a month. Thanks again for watching, and let us know if you have questions.